Hey everyone, Luke Gordon, physical therapist here. In today's video, we're talking about total knee replacement surgery, and I want to share four simple and effective ways that you can reduce the swelling in your knee at home following surgery. Now, if you just had surgery, one of the things you need to know is that the swelling in your knee and surrounding your knee is going to have a really big impact on your recovery, especially in the early phases of your rehab, where the number one thing you're focusing on is getting the knee to bend and straighten. You know, we call it range of motion in the PT world. So it's super important that you do everything you can in this early pre-surgical phase or post-surgical phase, excuse me, do everything you can to get that swelling down, because that's going to make that first number one goal of yours of getting your knee motion back, it's going to make it so much easier and less painful. So that's why we're talking about the topic. Another thing to keep in mind is that swelling for some people can be a long-term issue, as in like 6 months down the road, a year down the road, 2 years down the road. I've actually got a video on YouTube that talks about, you know, why does the knee continue to swell for so long and what can you do about it, which I'm going to share towards the end of this video. But suffice to say, the earlier you can get on top of the swelling, the better. And so that's why we're going to go through these four tips. So I'm going to go through the four tips, and then I've got a couple other things to share with you at the end of the video, bigger picture for your rehab process with the swelling and the motion, and what you can also do throughout the course of your rehab. But first off, like I said, easy, simple, effective, four things you can do at home to help speed this process up and just make it more comfortable with the swelling. So the first thing is an easy one. Hopefully you'll hear this from your surgeon and your PT, is you want to elevate your legs and do what we call ankle pumps. So ankle pumps is basically where you're just pumping your ankles up and down like that. Elevating your legs means essentially that you're laying roughly on your back. You know, you can be supported with a pillow, but you want your legs up above your heart. So use lots of pillows, use the arm of your couch. If you've got a wedge, you know, use a wedge. There's some nice wedges you can get online that aren't too expensive. We've got really nice ones at the clinic, which are expensive because we have to sanitize them and clean them. But for your home use, there's some nice ones you can get online. If I can find one, I'll post a link in the video below here, like on Amazon or something like that. So, but either way, regardless of how you do it, get those legs above your heart several times a day. Your knee is gonna swell a lot, by the way, after total knee surgery, and that's normal. It's a very invasive surgery. A lot of stuff's going on. The blood vessels are disrupted. So elevating your legs and doing those ankle pumps is gonna help pump some of that swelling back up into your circulatory system, back into your heart, and it's gonna relieve some of that swelling, which again will make your knee motion easier to attain. So that's number one, elevate and pump the ankles. Ice is another important one. Again, it's a very major surgery, total knee replacement, in terms of how much work they do, the disruption of the quadriceps muscle, the disruption and the tearing of the blood vessels. So you're gonna have lots of swelling, you're gonna have lots of heat and inflammation, and having a really good ice bag is going to be very helpful. Sometimes you'll get like an ice machine, like an Iceman they call it, from your surgeon. Not always, but either way, I think it's good to have a nice solid ice bag. Again, I haven't located one online yet that I really like. We have the ones that we carry in the clinic, which I really like. I'll find something similar, and hopefully by the time you watch this video, I'll have a link below in the comments, in the description, and then I'll share a nice ice bag with you. The good thing with the ice bag too, which you can ice your knee down, you know, 2, 3, 4 times a day, is that you can combine that with the elevation of the legs. So you kind of get two birds with one stone there. So again, have a nice ice bag ready before you go into surgery. The third point then, this is a really key one, is you really want to just find a balance between your activity level and your rest level. So there's kind of the two extremes. There's the folks after total knee surgery that just don't do enough. They're too sedentary. They sit on the couch all day. Their knee swells. It gets tight because they're just not moving it enough. You know, moving helps circulate your blood too. So the movement is going to help with your swelling. But then you got the other extreme, and those folks are moving too much. They're really active, especially if you're younger. You tend to be like, okay, a little more, like I can just work my way through this and more is more. But on that end of the extreme, more is less, because you can't change the fact that it was a major surgery and your body has to heal. So really try to find a balance between those two. I recommend people, you know, stay active like every hour, just kind of walk around, you know, move around a little bit, get outside, get some fresh air, and then rest. You also have to find a balance between how often you're stretching your knee and doing your exercises. Again, this is a little bit, you know, more individual, but again, you just want to appreciate that you really can overdo these things. So ultimately, I tend to get my clients to say like, well, let's not stretch 5 times a day. Let's stretch 2 to 3 and make it count. So that's your third tip, is really try to balance your activity level and your exercise level with the rest that you need to let your knee heal. The fourth one then is compression. So compression, we could be talking about like socks or stocking, you know, TED hose, things like that, that are gonna provide uniform compression throughout your leg to get that fluid to move back into your circulation. You may already be wearing a compression garment. If you're not, ask your surgeon, ask your therapist about that. And compression can be a big part of helping control the knee swelling. So those are the four tips. Those are pretty quick and easy. I wanna say a few more things about compression though. And compression can be done with a device as well when you're in therapy. So like a venous compression device. So run some of these things by your therapist if you're in PT already. And then if you have a lot of swelling, also ask your therapist what they can do with their hands to help move the swelling, so that swelling. Different therapists have different techniques they can use. And some therapists are only gonna do exercise-based techniques with you. But if they can actually help you manage that swelling and reduce the swelling with their hands, that's awesome. And then sometimes you want more of a specialized therapist who's specialized in like lymphedema to help you, because it could be not only just swelling, but also edema. So again, I won't go into that in today's video, but I'm gonna link a video at the end of this that'll explain a little bit more if you think you have more difficult problems with swelling, more of a long-term problem with edema and the lymphatic system and stuff like that. So make sure to run that by your therapist as well. See what they can do within your treatments to help you reduce your swelling in terms of the hands-on techniques and any of those compressive devices that I mentioned. Last thing that I wanted to mention is that ultimately, another thing that can really help with swelling, especially after your knee has, the incision has healed quite a bit, is aquatic therapy. So right now for us personally, we're not allowed to do aquatic therapy during COVID, but there should be some options hopefully in the near future for aquatic therapy. And that can be really valuable as well, as long as there's no risk of infection with your incision, which your surgeon will tell you when, because of that pressure gradient when you're in water. It's a very comfortable movement or environment to move around in as well, but the pressure gradient really helps with the swelling as well. So those are my other random tips. Make sure I got them all here. Make sure your PT helps you. I had one more. Also, if you're not quite into surgery yet and you're watching this video, if you have swelling in that limb or in your abdomen before surgery, there's stuff you can do before surgery to start working on the swelling before surgery. So keep that in mind as well. At the end of this video, I'm gonna link two videos. I'm gonna link one with more tips about how to control swelling and edema if it is more of a long-standing problem, because again, it can turn into something long-standing, or it may already be a long-standing problem for you going into surgery. So that video is going to help explain that a little more. And then the other video I'm going to link is the one that talks about why is your knee still swollen? If you've had a total knee and it's 6 months, a year, 2 years, what are all those factors that could be keeping your knee swollen? So hopefully today's, you know, four main tips helped, and then the other random stuff helped, and then the videos that I'm gonna post here help as well. As always, I'd love to hear if you have a comment or a question, just post it below the video. I do appreciate you watching. Please like the video while you're here and subscribe to the channel if you wanna see more. And like I said, I'll be happy to answer questions. Thanks for watching.